Ja, hallo ich und mein Lieben und willkommen zurück zu Let's Read Higurashi When They Cry. Ich wundere, ich bin noch ein kleines bisschen was erkältet, also falls ich mal mich ein bisschen komisch anhöre oder nicht aufstoße, zu Nase habe oder sowas. Ja, ich habe noch ein bisschen Erkältung, aber nicht ganz so schlimm, dass ich überhaupt gar nicht aufnehmen könnte und und ich muss halt wieder aufnehmen. Von daher, ja. Das erste Mal waren wir ja bei dieser komischen Szene stehen geblieben, wo Rena durchgedreht ist, so halb und ja, mal gucken. I was out of it and couldn't bring myself to do anything until dinner. I stared blankly into space. Und ich bin gerade erst aufgestanden, ja. Was I terrified from Rena going off on me? No, that's not right. That was someone else would look only looked like Rena. Then who could it have been? It was a dreadful feeling. Knowing that was someone else, not Rena. So tomorrow I shouldn't have a problem talking to Rena like I usually do. The thought was strangely comforting. I concluded that I should just calm down and clear my head. Though those thoughts continued swirling around my mind. Finally, I returned to my senses as I heard my mother calling out to me from the bottom of the steps. Kichi! It's a call from the bookstore. Bookstore? Can't think of why they'd be calling me. Und dann noch schlafen. I went downstairs and picked up the receiver anyway. My apologizes for calling so late at night. It's me, Oishi of the Okinomiya Bookshop. Oishi-san? Oh, it's Oishi-san. Sorry, since your parents picked up, said I was from the bookstore. It puts people off when I say I'm a police officer. Oishi-san was, in his own way, rather cautious. Even so, I didn't want my parents hearing me talk to the police. I brought the cordless phone with me as I dashed back up to my room on the second floor. Sorry for calling so late. That phone number on the piece of paper I gave you yesterday was the only old number. My apologizes. Can you copy down the number I'm about to give you? Ah, yeah. Okay. He gave me the number for his direct line as I wrote it down. I thought that was the end of it, but he began making pointless small talk and it was pretty hard to hang up. So how has it been, Maribara-san? Did anything strange happen recently? I see. This was the real reason. He really beat around the bush there. His all the conversational skills left me slack-jawed. Are you from around here, Oishi-san? Yeah, I am. Born and raised in Okinomiya. If he's from around here, he might know. Oishi-san, do you know what this Onikakushi thing is about? I believe that's when somebody suddenly vanishes because they have been abducted by a demon. It's a special saying from around here. It has the same meaning as spirited away, like everyone else says. Spirited away, war nochmal? Dictionary. Weggezaubert. Ach, weggezaubert. Ah, okay. Where else my friends would say they didn't know when I asked. This older man gave me the direct answer. Made me a bit happy then he answered me directly without trying to hide anything. In der Misawa was not sure if I should tell you this, Maribara-san. Don't try to play this off. If you are not going to talk, then I'm not going to tell you anything. Ah, no. That's not what I meant. It's just it may make you feel bad. You see, long ago, Hina Misawa was feared. Verdammt, was feared? Was feared? As the village where demons reside. Okay, demons? By demons, you mean those pitchfork carrying things in hell? More like human-eating monsters. They'd go down the villages, snatching people up and gobbling them down. That kind of tale. Also, wie heißen die Viecher hier in Japan halt, die besonderen, die ich weiß gar nicht, wie die heißen. Entschuldigung. Demon snatching up people is what this Onikakushi really means. They said that the curse and being demon away happened together. What does that mean? I already knew about the mysterious deaths happening 5 years in a row. But I didn't know there were people disappearing for those same 5 years. The curse and being demon away happened together. First time I've heard of that. Is that how it is, my brother-son? That's what I want to know. I heard Reina and Mion talking. They said if it was really Oyashiro-sama's curse, then both the curse and demoning away would happen. Oishi-san began hemming and having on the other end of the receiver. Maybe something about that came to mind. My brother-son, do you know the first incident? The murder by dismemberment? Yeah. One of the six perpetrators is still on the run, right? Hypothetically. What if he isn't on the run, but was demoned away? It was an outrageous hypothesis from Oishi's son. The incident four years ago was a particularly ghastly one. The police already knew the perpetrators, so they posted tons of wanted posters with his face on him. They stalked out all his locations and investigated every possible escape route he had. But after 4 years, there wasn't even a hint of where he might be, unless the police were completely incompetent. Even if it was an atrocious hypothesis, I couldn't simply laugh it off. And what about the incident the next year, when the man who supported the project and his wife both died in an accident? Well, actually, it was only the husband who died in an accident. His wife's body never surfaced. Unless we find a body, then it's considered a missing person by law. At the time of the incident, at the river below the cliff being muddy rapids. The police divers had searched every branch of the main stream of the river for dozens of miles, but in the end, they weren't able to find her body. But that's just them not being able to find her body. She's still dead, right? Isn't it different from her being demoned away? We cannot say something is dead without their body. Until a certain number of years pass, by law she's treated as still alive. I'm not sure if it was right to call the being demon away. The wife is missing. At least that part was reality. How about the third year? The Shinto priest died of illness, and his wife committed suicide. My brother-san, that's actually the exact same scenario. The wife had supposedly thrown herself into a bottomless marsh deep in the forest around Hina Misawa. Meaning it's all circumstantial evidence. They simply found her suicide note in front of the marsh. A diver was able to recover a few remnants, but they weren't able to find her body. The investigator headquarters believed that she had faked her death and was still alive somewhere. I'm not sure if we could call these cases as being demoned away. Just as you have said, every year one person does go missing. The incident this year, the woman with Tomitake-san has gone missing. What about the incident with the housewife beaten to death? Who went missing? I believe the perpetrator was caught, right? Yeah, we arrested him. He was just a miscreant with a record of narcotics abuse. He admitted to the crime by being questioned about a different incident. But, well, you see, after he was arrested, a child from the victim's home went missing. It's still under investigation as to whether the disappearance had anything to do with the crime. But you said you caught him, right? Did he have an accomplice? No idea. It's considered a separate case. Moreover, we can't even check now. Because while under investigation, that man, he died in his holding cell. He swallowed the spork and cock to death. That's a nice spork. Göffel. Was ist ein Göffel? Ach, das ist ein Löffel mit einer Gabelschneide. Aha, okay. Das hat daran verreckt. It's not known whether it was an accident or suicide. Meaning, for the last 5 years, there are always one person who dies and one who goes missing. That's about right. No, actually, I'm surprised as well. I never realized that they had that in common. I couldn't believe that this could have led to the closing of those incidents. It was just something they had in common. Could it be that those demons away have something in common? Oishi-san murmured as he seemed to be thinking about it. So I summarized these events. The first year was a dam employee. Second year was the wife of a dam project supporter. Third year was the wife of the Shinto priest. Fourth year was the victim's family child, and the fifth year was the victim's girlfriend, I guess. It doesn't seem like there's anything that connects them. The exception of the fifth year, wives and girlfriends, those still stand out. It does seem like there is a lot. Then that means fourth year's victim's child was different. It would have really stood out if it were all married couples. I expect it's not just married couples, but parents and children as well. Come to think of it, I believe Tomitake-san also told me the younger brother is alive and has moved, if I recall correctly. The child that went missing in the fourth year, who were they? Apparently he was quite major, 1 year older than you. His name was Satoshi. Moment mal. Satoshi Hoshiro-san. Okay. Ich glaube jetzt, das ist wahrscheinlich haben die hier Rena und die anderen. Oh Gott. Satoshi? I remember that name. Didn't they tell me Satoshi transferred out last year? He was at the school up until last year. Didn't they tell you anything about him? Come to think of it, and I transferred in, I believe they said me my seat belonged to a recent transfer student. Then, where I said, once belonged to the one who was deemed away. It was his seat? I recall a cold sensation that came from the desk and made my hair stand on end. The string of mysterious deaths. No, Oyashiro Sama's curse. And no one knew how it connected to me. The chilling sensation. It was the feeling of Oyashiro Sama caressing the back of my neck. Oyashiro Sama's curse, huh? Could Oyashiro Sama's curse really exist? In all honesty, I was beginning to believe it, and I was scared. That was why I wanted to say it was a plot crafted by man and not the work of a curse. But the more I dug into it, the less likely that seemed. No, the more I dug, the more mysterious it became. If I kept digging, eventually I'd reach the point where I'd learn something I really shouldn't know. To either be none the wiser or to seek an answer I might regret. Which one would I be happier with? Maybe it'll be my next time. My execution could only be delayed for 1 year. It was as I remembered. Rena. Rena said she may be the next victim of the curse. You mean Rena Yugo-san? She danced at Industry and she's your classmate, isn't she? This instance really might be a bit too disturbing for a girl. She's not just scared, is she? It wasn't that. She said it might be her next. She said it in a way that made me think she had a concrete reason behind it. It felt like she was convinced. Almost as if you could say she was frightened. A sudden change in demeanor. That someone who looked like Rena, but wasn't Rena. It might be unrelated. All the strange things that I felt from Rena today came back to me. I see. Then I'll be doing a bit of investigating on this end. Please continue your observations of Rigusan Maribarasan. Are you asking me to keep Rena under surveillance? Überwachung. Also, weiter unter Überwachung stehen. That's not what I mean, my brother. I just want you to watch out for her, for your friends, so she doesn't end up the next victim. At that moment, just as my mouth was agape because I was so impressed with his major, clever way with words. Knock, knock. A sudden knock at the door sent my heart racing. In an instant, I had pointlessly covered up the end of the receiver. Keiichi, get the door, please. On the other side of the door, I heard my father's oddly upbeat voice. What could it be? It's so late. Sorry, my dad just came in. Can we leave it at this for tonight? Yeah. My apologies again for calling so late. If you find out anything else, please let me know. I'll tell you if I make any progress to this end. Well, have a pleasant evening. Keiichi, hurry and open up. Daddy's got his hands full. What is that doing? I had stayed in the same position while on the phone the whole time, so my joints were aching. When I opened the door, I saw my father standing there with a tray. On that tray, cookies and 2 cups of black tea. A fairly fancy spread for our household. There was even sugar and lemon slices on the side. Everything you could ask for. This was quite a show of hospitality. Ja. What's going on, Dad? What's all this for? Come now, don't play around, Keiichi. I'm coming in. It was in high spirits and had a smirk on his face. But for my entire life, I've never seen him act this hospitable. What had gotten into him? So, what were you talking about? I jumped. It's not something I had to keep from my father. But how could I explain to him I was talking to a detective? I'm assuming he was this late at night. Nothing much. Just a friend. I don't mean the phone. She was here, wasn't she? Rina-chan. She wasn't here. Come now, don't try to keep it from me. She just came over to play. We two were chatting away, so I thought I'd bring her some tea, but looks like I just missed her. Was? I had no idea what Dad was talking about. But a cold sweat dripped down my back. How long were we talking? Rina and Sean went upstairs about half after, so it was close to an hour, I guess. You saw her come up to the second floor? Yeah, I did. I also told her that the room was the door down the hall up the stairs. Rina came to my house about an hour ago. Dad met her at the door and called out for me on the second floor. I probably didn't hear him because I was so focused on my conversation with Oishi. Oishi-san. I didn't reply, but he knew I was in the room, so he had her come in inside. Then told her my room was on the second floor. She thanked my dad and went upstairs. And about an hour passed. She passed by my dad just as he was bringing up tea and left. She came upstairs and about an hour passed. Then passed by my dad and returned home. Then, after she came upstairs, and until she left, there was Rina. It was only a short hallway between my room and the stairs. Meaning, Rina had for about an hour in the hall. No, she couldn't have been standing in front of my door all the time. No, my room wasn't particularly thick. You could easily hear everything being said inside. After all of the ominous things and all the nonsense I spoke to Oishi-san about began rushing through my head. Honey, don't tease him. More importantly, you need to clean up your studio. It's a mess again. Mom yelled up at Dad from downstairs. Dad left the tray with me and went downstairs with a disappointed chortle. I followed my dad out of the room with my eyes. I looked down at the floor around the doorway where Rina might have stood all the time. Just now, as I was talking to Oishi-san, with my back turned, Rina was standing a mere 6 feet away. The whole time? All the time. In the dimly lit doorway. What did she see? What did she hear? For what reason? As the steam from the two teacups ominously waved and twisted, the aroma of black tea filled my room. Uiuiuiui. Ja, da hat sie wahrscheinlich gelauscht, weil sie wissen wollte, ob er mit dem Typen redet. Und dann hat sie das wahrscheinlich jetzt rausbekommen. Und ist schon im Fall schief. Okay. Na dann. Warum ist er freigeschaltet? Leis. Leiterina. Okay. Notice from the poll ist schief. July 1st, 1982. The two departments 1 through 12. XX Prefecture Police Headquarters, Director General XXXX, XSX, to Chief Constable and, to Chief Constable and all Facility Managers. Regarding cases situated in Hinabisawa Village, notice. As cases in Chichibu in the city, Hinabisawa Village has been reported to be certain sections of mass media. It has drawn global attention, which is causing serious repercussions for the local residents. This has become a very serious situation. Hey, hallo! To protect the livelihood and prosperity of the residents, the following notice has been issued. First, designated following criminal investigations as classified. Okinomoya Station 182, case number X. Hinabisawa Village housewife murdered. Dated June XX. Okinomiya Station 182, case number X. Hinabisawa Village student disappearance. Dated June XX. Second, non-disclosure of information. Okinomiya Station 1979, case number X. Hinabisawa Village side foreman and murder. Shiro Station on Shiro Natural Park Feuerhelden Incident. Okinomiya Station, case number X. Hinabisawa Village Shinto Plus 5 disappearance. Okay. Third, requesting self-restraint from each organization concerning the release of sensitive information. Please see attached reference materials 1, 2 and 3. Management XX Prefecture Police Headquarters, Internal Line XXXX. Police Affairs Department XXXX. Okay. Oh, das war's wieder. Also, ich würde sagen, Safe Note. Wir machen hier mal einen Cut und sehen uns dann das nächste Mal bei Let's Read Higurashi in the Cry. Auf Wiedersehen, Leute. Auf Wiedersehen.